hear an interesting fact, like our euphoric feelings can come from our central nervous system producing endorphins, we don't often stop and think about the scientists who did years of research to make that discovery. We're going to go behind the facts and take a look at the scientists who discovered them. The misinformation effect is where our recollection of events becomes less accurate over time, because information after the event interferes with our original memory. One person behind this effect is American psychologist Elizabeth Loftus. In 1990, Loftus was asked to provide an expert testimony in a case where a woman rediscovered a childhood memory of a murder. But the repressed memory was only found during a therapy session and was the only evidence for the case. The case led Loftus to test the idea that vivid memories could be implanted in our minds simply by suggesting they happened. In one of her studies, she discussed with participants a time they became lost at the mall as a child. 25% of participants came to believe that they had truly been lost in the mall. They even fabricated detailed memories surrounding the event that were not discussed with her. Loftus has since testified in over 250 cases, and as a result of her work, we know there's no such thing as a memory locker. There are little caps at the end of our DNA strands called telomeres that protect our chromosomes. Each time our cells divide, the telomeres get shorter, and over time, having shorter telomeres is associated with aging and mortality. In 1984, Australian scientist Elizabeth Blackburn was instrumental in discovering telomerase, an enzyme that repairs telomeres. Blackburn and her colleagues won a Nobel Prize for the discovery in 2009. She's since discovered many illnesses are related to shortened telomeres. People with heart disease, for example, have shorter telomeres than their peers without heart disease. Basically, her discovery may redefine how we look at illness. Sadly, it's predicted that 1 in 85 people will suffer from Alzheimer's disease by the year 2050, although two molecules from the root of a native Indian plant have been shown to eliminate Alzheimer's symptoms and reduce the buildup of plaque in the brain. An Indian scientist behind the 2012 study, Vijayalakshmi Ravindranath, showed these effects in the brains of mice. It's a beginning stage, but since current medication is synthetic and only slows the effects of Alzheimer's, the discovery could benefit the lives of millions of people. And just in case you were wondering, we know that producing endorphins leads to euphoric feelings because American neuroscientist Candace Pert discovered our brain's opiate receptor in 1972 as a graduate student. It's the cellular site where our body's painkillers and blissful endorphins bond with cells to do their thing. If you know a cool story of a scientist behind a fact or discovery, let me know down below in the comments. And if you don't already, subscribe to Braincraft for a new brainy video every Thursday. And check out these other awesome videos my friends have put together for International Women's Day, because pizza rolls, not gender rolls.